A pattern is a small image that is being repeated inside an area until that area is filled up with the pattern. I open the Patterns panel by clicking on the Configure tab, Add tab, Patterns. To fill a layer with a pattern, simply drag a pattern icon on the canvas. I will increase the preview size of the pattern thumbnails by going to the Configure tab, Preview size, Enormous. Now we can see patterns can have different sizes. They don't have to be square, and they also can have transparency. The patterns at the bottom are Gimp's default patterns. The patterns at the top are patterns I have downloaded. At the end of this lecture, I will show you where you can download free patterns. Let's have a look at some examples of what you can create with patterns. I can create a metal surface or a grass background in any size I want. A pattern can also have transparency, as we see with this pattern. You can create a background of wood or a brick wall. You can create a paper texture, wrinkled paper, or have a beach sand background. Now, let's make a pattern ourselves. I would like to have a water pattern. I open water. I will crop out a piece of water that looks interesting. I select the crop tool, drag and resize. I press enter to crop. Next, we make the pattern seamless. This means that the pattern can be repeated without showing visible transitions. I will use a filter for this. I go to Filters, Map, Tile Seamless. Now the pattern is seamless. To place the pattern in the Patterns panel, I first have to save it. I go to File, Export As. I will name it Water. At the bottom, I click on Select File Type and scroll down until I see GIMP Pattern. I select it. At the top, I see the file now ends with .pat. I save the pattern in the GIMP 2.10 folder, where we have placed the plugins. Under Places, I click on Boot C. Then I double-click on Users, then I double-click on the name of my PC, then App Data, and then Roaming. In the Roaming folder, we see the GIMP folder. Now we see a folder called 2.10. Before I double-click on the Patterns folder, I could bookmark the Patterns folder if I plan to make more patterns. At the bottom, I click on Export. And click on Export. Now I click on the Refresh Patterns button in the Patterns panel, and the water pattern is added to the panel. I drag it on the canvas to see the result. You can delete a pattern by clicking on the trash can. The patterns I showed before are downloaded from textures.com. You have to subscribe to download textures. I have a free subscription, which gives a limitation in the amount of textures I can download per day. Let's say I am looking for a grass pattern. At the top there is a search field. I type grass. when I hold my mouse above a texture, I can see whether the texture is seamless, which means I can directly use it as a pattern. When I click on a texture, I can download it. The downloaded file will be a JPEG file, because JPEG, PNG, GIF and TIFF files also can be used as patterns. I can place the JPEG file directly in the patterns folder. In the next lecture, we will look at making duotone images.